because of my approach to competition, that I always feel like, you know, that a lot of our evolution gets held back because we protect information, because it's really about, I'm going to try to beat you. So if I know something that I think I can beat you with, I won't tell you, because then you'd have it too, and I wouldn't be able to beat you. But if my objective is to make you be as good as you can be, and I'm going to try to be as good as I can be, I will be like, you can't believe this, try this. And so that's more how I approach things. And I think because of, especially like in big wave riding, when we've gone out and done the things we've done, that it has to do with the fact that we've done it with camaraderie. We've done it with community. And really the evolution of man, if you looked at why man survived, was because of that was the way we behaved. Mm-hmm. And it was only when we became so populated and so dense did we create competition, was more out of entertainment, mm-hmm. that really competition was designed for entertainment. That's why we have competition. Wow. And at the end, fighting and all these things that we have, they're not real fighting, because real fighting doesn't last very long, and it's very brutal. It would be, it would never be, you wouldn't watch it on TV, and it wouldn't be something that, and you wouldn't just do it unless you were planning on actually killing a person.
Yeah.
So, and there's also this thing about the, you know, that everybody being able to do it, like true arts, true fighting or true activities are meant that a child should be able to do it, and an old person should be able to do it, to make it something that really is for the species.
Yeah.
So when it comes to toe-in and what you guys are doing, relying on each other, maybe you could talk to just the intensity of the camaraderie that is built through those moments where you literally are on this precipice.
Well, it's survival.
It's
a survival thing. I mean, I'm not gonna glorify it and try to say it's anything like going to war, but there's an aspect to it that's like, you know, like being in battle. Like you go out and buddy's next to you, and you're gonna put yourself on the line for him, and he's gonna put himself on the line for you, and perform the best we can in these giant waves. Documenting what we were doing was part of it, and then showing the documentation was part of it. Because we felt like there was a lot of stuff going on in surfing, and we were like, hey, listen, well, we're doing something that's like on another level. So
exactly. There was a lot going on in surfing, but nothing, not even remotely close to that. When Wake Up Call. Exactly. I want to go back to early 90s in the islands, you and the Strap crew, and the organic way that all that stuff happened. Can you kind of give us a broad brush of how it all transpired?
You know, a lot of it came out of a nucleus of people that you're kind of bouncing ideas off of. That 90s gang, we were trying to problem solve together, so we had a lot of minds and a lot of energy around the effort. Big wave riding probably is the most exciting discipline in surfing.